The advice I would give to anybody who is about to open and design a tiki bar is don't do it.
I've been waiting all my life to do this project.
You've got to do a build out that gives you that transformative Polynesian atmosphere. That's expensive.
Well, they first have to care about the cocktails.
Yeah.
It should get you by the sounds that are around you.
Colorful, weird lighting.
You're in the South Pacific,
escaping to paradise.
It's a vibe.
This bar will be a destination place dedicated just to tiki mugs.
So how many mugs do you currently have, Fini?
It's got to be around 1,000.
Fini operates in a world that oftentimes I think is fantasy. And there's many times that I would have walked away from our partnership.
I didn't really know about this subculture with collecting tiki mugs until this job.
Sven Kirsten's Book of Tiki came out in 1998, and it was his chapter on tiki mugs. It kickstarted this new art form.
I wanted tiki to re-enter pop culture.
This is an artist movement.
He's out every weekend to Palm Springs and Tiki Oasis. And he laid the new budget on me last week, and it's three times what he said.
What I'm trying to do is something that's so over the top and purist and still pushing forward in tiki, keeping one eye on the past. We take this door out and we put it here.
This is gonna be good.
Honestly, I don't think anybody would do anything if they knew what they were getting themselves into.